Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in the chapter that is gravitation, we were talking about that of the gravitational force. We discussed about that of the Newton's third law of motion and the gravitation. What is the Newton's third law of motion state, students? So Newton's third law of motion, it states that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. Okay, it means if an object is there and you apply a force on it, it will apply the same amount of a force on the first object. Okay, so how it is related to that of the gravitation? So you see, students, that if suppose a object is there and it is exerting a gravitational force on the other object, so the first object will also exert the same amount of a force to the first object. Okay, so we can say that since the same amount of a force is exerted by the opposite direction by the second object on the first one, so it is somehow related to that of the Newton's third law of motion. So Newton, he himself explains about it, that how this law work, and he explains that how it is related to that of the gravitation. So you see, students, when a ball is coming from the upward direction to the downward, due to the gravitational force exerted by the earth on the ball, so you will say that why does it occur? So it occurs due to the force exerted by the earth on the ball. Now the question arises that is the ball will also exert the same amount of a force on the earth? And if is it so, then why not the earth is moving in the upward direction? So basically what happens here, yes, the first answer is the yes, that ball will also apply the same amount of a force on that of the earth. But since the mass of the earth is much more, so we cannot see such kind of a movement. And this can be proved with the help of the Newton's second law, which explains that force is equal to mass into acceleration, or acceleration is equal to force upon mass. So mass is what? Inversely proportional. So more will be the mass, less will be the acceleration. Less will be the mass, more will be the acceleration. So ball is smaller in size, smaller in mass. So less mass is there, students, so more acceleration will be there. And that is why you can see that the ball, which is coming in the downward direction due to the gravitational pull, can be seen. But due to very large mass, acceleration will be nil, or acceleration will be very low. So it is not possible for us to see that the earth is moving in an upward direction. Okay, so this is how the Newton's law is related to that of the gravitation. Now you see, student, the next one that we were discussing also is a free fall. Free fall. What is a free fall, students? So you see, if we will throw anything in the upward direction, it will start coming to the downward. Or if you drop a ball from a height, it will start coming to the downward direction. So that is what, that is a falling of the object. Okay. So if only the gravitational force is acting on a falling object, object which is coming towards the earth, that kind of a fall is known as a free fall. It means it is free from any kind of a other force acting on it, that is known as a free fall. Okay, I already had written that of the definition of the free fall. Let me write it again. The falling of the body towards the earth, from a height, due to gravitational force, or height under the gravitational force. under a gravitational force, that falling of the object is known as a free fall. So falling of the object towards the earth from a height under the gravitational force is called as a free fall. Now this we have understood students, that when an object is coming towards the earth or the surface, or when it is dropped from a certain height, the only if the gravitational force is working on it, that we call as a free fall. Now you see students, we have seen that if suppose we are throwing the two objects from a certain height, you will find that one of the object reaches first and the other object reaches afterwards. Like if we take the two examples, if suppose we will take an example of a paper and stone, what will you observe? If suppose you are throwing both of them, means a paper is there students and a stone is there, and you are throwing both of them or dropping both of them from a certain height, what will you observe? You will observe that this paper will reaches later than that of the stone, because the stone is what? It is the heavier one, it is a heavy object. So when you throw the stone in the downward direction, this stone will reaches late than that of the paper. Okay, so it means we can say that here this one, you can say that because of the heaviness, because of more density, it will reaches first, and since it is the lighter one, it reaches later. So it means that the gravitational force, or we can say that that is the acceleration, because you see student, if object is coming in the downward direction, there will be increase in the acceleration of the velocity keeps on increasing. So we can say that there will be increase in the acceleration. So since the acceleration is continuously increasing when the object is falling towards the earth surface, so more acceleration will be there. So here it must depend upon the mass, and because of that we can say that one is coming down, one is coming later, and the first is one is coming at first. Okay, because you see student, one is of heavier, one is the lighter. So this one is having more mass, this one is having less mass. So both of them are coming towards the earth surface. Okay, both of them have been dropped from the same height. Okay, so if one is coming first and the other one is in the later, so we can say that it is maybe the acceleration of the stone is a higher than that of the paper, and that is why it reaches first. So is it a correct statement? No. How? Later on, Galileo, he performed an experiment. He dropped two stones, and both of the stones reaches to the earth surface at the same time. Okay, then he concluded by that acceleration does not depend upon the mass of the body. Okay, so if two objects are there and it is dropped from a certain height, both of them will reaches to the surface at the same time. Let me write it and then explain to you. See, irrespective of the mass, reaches to the earth surface from the same height at the same time. So if the two objects are there which is dropped from a certain height at the same time, so we can say that irrespective of the mass, both of them will reaches to the earth surface, strike to the earth surface at the same time. Now you will say, how is it so? Because we are knowing, if suppose you take example of a feather and that of a coin, so if you throw both of them from a height, you know that the coin will reach first. Here also in this case, the stone is reaching first. So why we are saying that the paper and the stone will reach at the same time? So here students, since the surface area of the paper, surface area of the feather in case of a feather and coin is more, so more air resistance will work there, and due to that it will not allow that object, the material to come at the same time, at the time when the stone strikes to the earth surface. Okay, so we can say it is because of the large surface area, the air resistance will resist its motion, its speed, and finally the acceleration get decreases. So there students, we can say that mass, we do not depend upon the mass, but there are some other factors which is responsible in slowing down the speed of the object. Now you will say that this happened in the air. What will happen if suppose we will take in the vacuum? Yes, in the vacuum, if you take the paper and the stone or that of the feather and the coin and drop it from a certain height, you will observe that the feather and the coin will reach to the surface at the same time, and same thing happened with the paper and the stone. The paper and the stone will also reach at the same time. So it is because of the air resistance there is a change in the acceleration, otherwise acceleration does not depend upon the mass of the object. So we can write it, the acceleration of a freely falling body does not depend upon the mass of the body. Okay, so it does not depend upon the mass of the body of the object. Okay, so basically you can say student, that Robert Boyle performed an experiment throwing or dropping of an object, two object dropping two objects from a certain height, and what are the two objects student? It can be feather and stone. So he has taken feather and a stone, he drops the two objects from a certain height. The most important thing is there student, in vacuum. What was the observation student that we find? So both the object reaches to the earth surface at same time. Okay, so you see student, Robert Boyle, he performed an experiment that if we draw the two object in vacuum, he has taken a space and then from with the help of a vacuum pump he evacuated all the air from it, making it a vacuum free from air, and then he dropped both of the object, student, feather and the stone, and he find that both of them reaches to the surface at the same time, which proves that it does not depend, acceleration does not depend upon the mass of the object. Okay, so we can say that this proves, this proves that acceleration does not depends on the mass. Okay, it does not depend upon the mass of the object. So this was all about that of the mass of a freely falling body. Mass of a freely falling body. Okay, so it does not depend upon the mass of a freely falling body. This was explained by Robert Ball. So this is all about that of a free fall, student. That what is a free fall, and how can we see that a freely falling two objects acceleration? How the acceleration occurs, student? Because when it is coming towards the earth, there is an increase in the speed. There is an increase in the velocity. And due to the increase in the velocity, acceleration also increases. A uniform acceleration generated. So we can see that there is no change in the acceleration in the two of the object if we will perform the same thing in a vacuum. Because when we throw or when we drop the two object in the air, there the air resistance work, and this will help in reducing the speed of the object. Now we will understand the next topic, and which is a very very important one, and that is acceleration due to gravity. So right now also, students, we are continuously talking that when an object is dropped from a certain height, when an object is thrown from a certain height, na? So here acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. Okay, now you see, student, if suppose an object is dropped from a certain height. When an object is dropped from a certain height, its acceleration is increasing at a uniform rate. Okay, so we can say that it's when an object is dropped from a certain height, due to the gravitational pull, so it will comes to the earth surface with a uniform acceleration, and such kind of an acceleration which is formed due to the gravitational pull or due to gravity, such kind of an acceleration is known as acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so acceleration due to gravity, which is also represented by small g, it is produced when an object is dropped from a certain height. Acceleration keeps on increasing, and ultimately it will causes the makes, we call it as the acceleration due to gravity. So we can say that when an object, is dropped from a certain height, its acceleration, or we can say a uniform acceleration is produced. In it by the gravitational pull. What is a gravitational pull, student? You can see that the earth is attracting it towards itself. That is a pull. So it is due to the gravitation. So we will use the term for it, that is a gravitational pull. So due to this gravitational pull, there is a uniform acceleration is produced, and we call such kind of a acceleration as a acceleration due to gravity. So we can say that the uniform acceleration, which is produced? Which is produced due to the acceleration? Due to the gravitational pull. Acceleration which is produced in a freely falling body. In a freely falling body. Due to the gravitational force are called acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so acceleration due to gravity basically occur when there is a production on that of a uniform acceleration when the object falls freely due to that of the gravitational pull acting on it. Okay, now we will represent the acceleration due to gravity by small g. You see, the universal gravitational constant is represented by capital G, and the acceleration due to gravity depends, or it is written as small g. Okay, small g. One more thing is there, that on what factor the g depend does not depend. Students, you see, student, we will say that it when an object is falling downward, it does not depend upon the masses. The acceleration does not depend upon the mass. So since this uniform acceleration is produced due to the freely falling body, due to that of the gravitational pull, so that also does not depend upon the mass of the body. So we will say that g does not depends on the mass of the body. Okay, g, it does not depend upon the mass of the body. So it does not depend upon the mass of the body. What is the value of the g, students? So most of the, actually its value it differ from place to place, but most of the time we use the value of the g is 9.8 meter per second square. Why we are taking at a meter per second square, students? It is because it is an acceleration, and we know that the SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Okay, so we can write it, that is the value of a small g is the value of a small g is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, so you can say that when an object is coming in the downward direction, it falls, the freely falling body, it falls with an acceleration of 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, so acceleration when a body it comes towards the earth in the downward direction, so acceleration keeps on increasing, student, and that acceleration increases with the 9.8 meter per second square. The same thing happens when you throw a ball from in the upward direction. So there, since it is against the acceleration, it is opposite in the direction of the acceleration due to gravity, so there it will be the negative acceleration because it is going in the upward direction. The acceleration occur in the upward direction, so there the value of the g will be there 9.8 meter per second, but it will be the negative one, so we will take it as a 9.8 meter per second square, minus 9.8 meter per second square. And this keeps on decreasing. You see, student, minus is there, so it means it keeps on decreasing. Ultimately, it will becomes, when it becomes zero and finally it will starts coming down. So we can say that when it is coming coming in the downward direction, when it is a free fall body, at that time the acceleration of the body is 9.8 meter per second square. And when you throw a object in the upward direction, which is against to that of the gravity in the opposite direction, so there the acceleration keeps on decreasing at 9.8 meter per second square. Finally it becomes zero, and ultimately it will start coming in the downward direction again. Okay, so this one is the acceleration due to gravity. Now, how can we find the acceleration due to gravity? How can we calculate the acceleration due to gravity, students? So let us write it. So you see, acceleration due to gravity. Calculation of our acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. How can we calculate it? So you see, students, in a short form, if we talk about how to calculate it, so you see that we know that according to the that of the universal law of gravitation, a formula which is given, that is the F is equals to G into m1 m2 upon r square. Right, so this is what, this is the first equation. Okay, now you see here, students, since we are taking here the acceleration due to gravity occur from one mass, first mass, if you are taking the mass of the first object as a small mass and the second one as a capital mass, and the distance between these two as a r square, so capital R, so it will be mm r square. Okay, now according to the Newton's second law of motion, we know that F is equals to what, mass into acceleration, or we can say acceleration is equals to F upon m, and this is what, this is the second equation. Now, when we put the value of the this one into that of the first one, what we will get? So you see, students, it will be this way. This mass will come to this side, and F by m is equals to g into m upon r square. Okay, so F by m, it will be also known as that of the acceleration is equals to g m upon r square. Since here we are talking about the acceleration due to gravity, so instead of taking it as a AA, we will use in place of a GA as a G. Okay, so G will be equals to GM upon r square. Okay, so whenever you have to derive the equation, at least you have to write it. Simply I had done it, I'll again do it again tomorrow. But you see, student, let me explain you, then I'll do it by writing. So you see that at the first equation, we are knowing that this one, force is equals to g into mm upon r square. Here we have taken mass of a first object is m, small m, and mass of the second object as a capital M, and the distance between these two is radius is the distance between these two is r, so we have taken it as a capital R. So r square, force is equals to mass into acceleration, we know that is the second law of equation. So this will be equals to acceleration is equals to force upon mass, and acceleration, if we put the value of the acceleration in the force upon mass, so you see, student, if this mass will come to this side, it will become F by 1, F by m is equals to g into capital M upon r square, and this F by m is equals to acceleration. Since we are talking here about the acceleration due to gravity, so instead of taking the A is equals to gm upon r square, we will use the another term for it, and that is small g is equals to capital G upon capital M upon r square. So this is how we can derive that of a acceleration due to gravity. Many times student the question is asked that how the acceleration due to gravity is related to that of the universal gravitational constant, or sometimes the question is asked that shows the relationship between small g and capital G. In both of the cases you have to derive this expression. In tomorrow class we will understand with the help of this formula that how we will get the value of this small g. Okay.